So, who want to ask? Who has question? Can ask.
I've tried many forms of meditation. I quite enjoy meditation. I'm more calm, but I seem to get not through any layer actually. Whatever meditation I try, and I want to ask you advice. Which meditation or what technique or what I should try or where I should start to get through any of these layers.
What means your layers? Layers what means?
Yeah, to get to your deeper self, to try to get through these layers, to get through your deeper self. I don't
have the feeling I get there. First thing is understand meditation only is that thing which you cannot do as you want. It is not you do meditation and you go, can go in deeper and deeper. Can go and can't go. Depend on how your meditation is strong. Only you can do any technique, which technique you like. Many techniques here about meditation. And every meditation technique brings you inside, more deep. But this is not like if you're doing meditation and it happened. Can be quick and can be take long, long time also. People sitting, doing meditation 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, even life, some lives. Continuous meditation. Then it happened. But this is sure, if you do meditation, some you go inside, start to going, looking. And you also don't know how much deeper you going. You can't feel it much. Only you can feel, okay, you are more calm, more less mind, more joy, more in heart, more relax. This can feel. But what happening, how many layers you did or not did, you cleaning the layers or deeper, this you mind cannot know it. Only mind can go, but don't know. Because he don't know what is the map, how it is going. Only your being, your heart will say, yeah, something is going right. Something I feeling difference. But what difference and how much you touch deeper or not deeper, how much you, very difficult to you know. And self will happen one time it will happen. That is called enlightenment. But for enlightenment, you have to go on journey, meditation. But depend on your thirst, how much you want. If you want really fully, can be now. But if your thirst is not very strong, like 10%, 20%, 30%, 50%, which day 100%, then it will happen. 100% means, like one master was in India, Arvindo, Maharshi Arvindo. And he saying one word in Hindi, your thirst will be like a abhipsa. So abhipsa means like you, from work, you come back in your home. 8 hours work, 10 hours work, you are tired, you are want to rest, come back to home. As you came back, you seen enter in home, enter in room, and one just glass water was there on table. Even you not thirsty, you don't want. It's okay, but water is there, just you take some. This is one type thirst. Then you come back again and very thirsty, like very, very thirsty. And just you straight come in home, go straight to fridge, refrigerator, open, take the bottle and drink very fast. It is also thirst, much more, this is thirst. But he said, this is also not real thirst yet. And then he said, abhipsa. Abhipsa means just you are very thirsty. Just suppose you going in desert. In desert. Sand. Sun is very hot. You are totally finished almost. You no have water also. You no have anything. And you have to going on, walking. Sand is very hot, sun is very hot. And you want only, maybe I get half glass water. Somehow. And somebody say, you are ready to give everything for water. Everything. Only one glass water give me. You can take my all money, all my property, I can put in your name, but one glass water. Otherwise, I die. One step very difficult to put more, if one glass water not come. So he said, this thirst like a abhipsa. Just everything, you not thinking about anything. And then, if this thirst you have, then enlightenment, you get the self. Because you don't want anything else. Same story, one more happened with one master. One master living in Banaras. He has his house. His name was Ramatirtha. One man came from long way. He said, I heard about you. Man can change with you. Early morning he came. And Ramatirtha going to river to bath. He said, okay, I going in bath, river. You also came. Come with me. First we take bath. And then after we will talk. First I will take bath, eat little bit. And then we talk. Then they both went, both going. Ramatirtha just took his cloth, go in river. This man also going in river, taking bath, start swimming, start. Ramatirtha is bit strong man, stronger than him. So as this man going inside in river, go in, Ramatirtha came and sit on him and drawn him. And this man want, what is this? He not understand, like somebody on him, and he can be finished, he cannot come out from river. So he do, one time try not happening, because Ramatirtha was strong. Second time he trying to go out, otherwise his breath is not coming slowly. He cannot get the breath. And then finally, when he last moment came, like he could not get the breath, and he just full power, took his full power and throw him there and came out. First he very huffing, taking breath, and then came out from river and just shouting on him, abusing his start. What are you doing? You are master, or you are killer, You want to kill me? Ramatirtha also came out and he just angry, very angry, this man on him. Naturally, can be. Then after 5-10 minutes, he slowly he getting okay, quiet. Abuse finished, anger little bit finished. And Ramatirtha very quiet, stand there, listening him. Okay, do whatever, say whatever you want to say. Then when he silent, Ramatirtha said, when you throw me out, what you think, what thoughts you have? He say, what thoughts? He say, you remember your wife, family? He say, no wife there, no family there. He say, you remember your money, your business, your work? He say, no work. He said, then what you want that moment? When you fully took me and throw me out from you. He said, just I want one breath. Last breath, one breath. Otherwise I die. And that moment, no, cannot think anything. Can't think. He said, you thinking also, you came to me? You remember me? He said, no. You thinking you want to change? You say you want to come, want to change yourself? He said, no. No, any thoughts? Just one breath. Last breath. Otherwise, I finish. I will die. So Ramatirtha said, which moment? Only you have, you want to get yourself. Nothing else. No anything else. No any other desire. No any other want. No any other wish. That moment I change you. Even no need to come to me also that moment. You will be changed wherever you are. So he said, this thirst like a abhipsa. You can give everything. So which day you have this thirst coming, you straight reach in your being. No anything can stop you. No anything can block you. But thirst is not like this. Slowly in satsang, coming with master, listening him, doing meditation, follow him, then your thirst is getting bigger, more and more and more. And one day, this thirst come, 100%, boom. Nobody can stop. You straight go like an arrow in your being. You can't stay anywhere, can't stop yourself. You have to go, because you don't have any wish other. You feeling this is the last moment for me. I will not see anything here more. I can't open eyes also. So many times when meditators doing meditation, maybe whole life, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, doing. And last moment when they die, when they leaving the body, that moment happened. Many people become enlightened that moment when they leaving the body. Because that time they looking no wish. Because they know, now I go. No my mother, no my father, no my husband, no my wife, no my kids, no my work. Everything he looking is finishing now. That time no wish coming more. And if you did meditation, then more stronger. And then that moment when you know, oh, I don't get anything, I don't want anything even. When anybody dying, what want? Nothing. He knows wife is finishing, husband is going away. Everything, whatever I gain, I get in whole life, whatever happened, it finishing now. In within moment can be finished. Don't know when. Maybe I stay 5 minutes more, maybe 10 minutes more, maybe half hour more, or maybe now. So that moment his wish almost finished. And that moment when enlightenment means you getting in self which day your wish finish. You don't want anything. And slowly meditation makes you finish your wish. Mind, what is mind? mind is full of wish, full of desires. Desires and desires and desires. Now you look, you just close eyes when you're sitting. Close eyes, look. Mind produce you. I want this, I want this, I want this, I want this. Big list. Even you cannot write how many desires you have in 1 hour. Because mind always, this is mind. Mind living with desires. So when your desires will slowly, slowly, as you say, when meditation happening, you coming more deeper, automatic your mind getting less, desire getting less. Desire no much, less, 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 and one day no desire. Which day, which moment, no desire, you are self, you in self. Only mind, this desires is barrier, block you. Otherwise, no anything can stop you. And all process of meditation, how my mind can be quiet, how I can finish the mind, how I can finish my ego. And which day mind, ego finish? And as your mind is less, you more go deeper and deeper and deeper. Automatic. But you cannot know 1 second before even how much deep you are. Feels okay, I'm very good, my meditation very good going, I like, I enjoy. But don't know how far you are from self. You don't know. One moment before, you don't know also. When you're reaching in being. You can't know one moment before also. That happened with this moment. And you gone. Mind is swap. Mind is finished. Mind is pop. This can happen. But meditation makes us slowly, 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 our desires is finished. And desire will be finished only when you get the taste of your being. As you coming to being, you more relax, more calm, more joyful, more good love, positive, then automatically you going away from mind. Mind always negative, this. Complain, I don't like this, I don't want this, and I want this, so many desires, and many things he don't like, complain, negative. Slowly, slowly your mind become first positive, and then one day positive, and then one day when fully positive, he will be finished, he will go. That day you get you in consciousness, you are fully yourself, you know yourself. So this is process, but go on, depend on your thirst, how much you want. If you're thirsty now, only this half hour enough, 5 minutes even enough. If no thirsty, okay, go on. One master was Buddha, same like giving satsang. Everybody listening him, suddenly one man came. Same thing, he just sit, close eyes, bow down him, and he said, one question, I have no nothing else, I want to reach myself. Or you can do anything, can make Buddha look, put hand on his head, and in him energy arising very fast. Om sound is buzzing start in him, everywhere. And then Buddha took up back his hand. He 2, 4, 5 tears came in him, this man. Say, bow down. Say, yes, you did. You done. And he left. Many disciple is sitting with him. Years, half years. One was very close. His name was Ananda. He very like a caretaker. He say, what happening? What's going on? This man came and he asked you, you can transform him, change him. You put hand. And we seen also. we seen this man really changed, fully changed. His aura changed, his face changed, he's like a shining like a sun within 5 minutes. What's going on? He say, this man is very near to being, just touching, just in on being, not reach, not jump, just last moment, last hit he has need, last push. For this he came, and I just touch. And Ananda say, you never touch anybody? He say, because no need, and he need this last push, then I did. I just put hand, and last push happened. And within few second, minutes, he changed. And he say, we are listening you, somebody 1 year, somebody 5 years, somebody 10 years, nothing happened. He say, you are not fully ready yet. There. He was ready. He on the border. Just. And then to him happened. And you are becoming ready slowly, slowly. He don't have any other thing. He don't want any other thing. Except finish. And the finish happened. And he said to him, which day you will be like this? Then only one sitting enough. Even you sitting in your room and you with me will happen there. So meditation makes you slowly, slowly prepare to ready, to go there, to ready to finish our own ego, finish own mind. Very difficult. Mind want to finish mind. Who want? And mind say, like if you say, anybody say, okay, I want to do suicide. Many times happened to people. Very depressed, very frustrated. Oh, I go suicide. But it is when they go also, many times come back. No easy. When they're looking, jumping and from cliff, from mountain, are hanging the neck, no power, no courage. Nobody has courage. Suicide also very courageous people, need very courage. Nobody can do, even bed to bed, very depressed, very frustrated. Man, every day thinking, okay, I finish myself, because no any hope here, no any joy here, I can't get anything, but no have courage also. For that also, for suicide, very courage is need very much. They are courageous. Who can kill himself? And this is just body killed, body finished. And now, meditation, you going to kill your mind, like you. You kill to you. Nobody very difficult, just take knife and put him. To you can put to others easy. But to himself, almost impossible. Nobody. Very much angry or whatever, but very difficult to kill self. So meditation means you killing your mind to you. Because now we thinking we are the mind. And everybody govern with mind. Everybody go with mind. Mind say go here, go here. Mind say do this, do this. Mind say you are good, good. Mind say you are bad, bad. No. Because self which day you know, then mind will be not work. Mind will not say. Will say, but you not listening it. You know, mind is not me. I am in self. Then, but this process of meditation, inner journey, spiritual journey, to make ready to mind, when he say, I want finish. Really, I want to finish. I have enough. I know this mind game, ego game I did. I know cunningness of mind, selfishness of mind. He is very clever, very cunning. He can lie to everybody, he can cheat everybody, he can use everyone. When you looking this thing, and then you say, no, I don't want. Because your heart when opened, then you can see the mind also. Heart will see, heart is light, light will see the dark. And then you say, okay, finish now. I have enough. I have enough ego game. This is not only this life, many life. And I say to you, what you doing now in this life? It is not anything new. No new. You did many, many times. Many times you married, many times you children, many times you work. This is not new anything. You just repeat. In whatever you're doing in life, it is repetition. Many times you do. Therefore, repetition, therefore you not enjoy. After some time feel, oh no. Boring. Something want new. Something want, some new has to happen. Because every day same, look slowly feel nothing, enjoy. But we did this thing many times. Only you not did one thing to reach the self. That is new for you. Will be new. Which day you reach. Which day your mind. So, but slowly, as you go, mind dissolve. And but mind don't know how much dissolve. Only can feel less mind. Mind is more less, more is calm, more is quiet, more relaxed. This. But also going relax. You are very good. Maybe don't know anything happened. Maybe your night is not good. Sleep or anything. Morning you big mind. This is also not you coming to satsang every day same. One day very good. Wow. And one day very disturbed. Can be disturbed. Because your disturbance come out. You have disturbance. Sometimes very emotional coming. Sometimes very disturbance coming. Sometimes very okay. When your energy is relaxed, coming more to being, relax. So both can happen. But you go on and just meditation. Which technique you like? And if you have, we have few techniques. Which technique your heart will say, yes, I like it. I enjoy. In this technique after and in meditation, I feel, wow, very good. Like a blessing, very joyful. So every day go on this technique. This is your key. Key you have now, just go. Open. One day lock will be open.